I am of the belief that, of course, Democrats should have done everything to not have Neil Gorsuch even be have a hearing. I think that they should walk out en masse. They all should deliver opening statements the way Senator Sheldon Whitehouse did, which is like, hey, look, you're an extreme ideologue. You're the product of a corporate infrastructure which is distorted profoundly, democracy and accountability in every aspect of this society, and you're there to pass 5-4 extreme far-right decisions that will roll back voting rights, workers' rights, women's rights, and make the country more and more firmly in the mold of 21st century feudalism and Merrick Garland, Merrick Garland, Merrick Garland, Merrick Garland, goodbye. But they are having these hearings, and here is Senator Chuck Schumer saying on the Senate floor that it is, quote-unquote, unseemly for the process to be moving so quickly with Gorsuch, given the cloud hanging over the Trump administration. Let's play this clip. I'll give you my review after.
Before I move on to another topic, I'd like to point out that it is the height of irony that Republicans held this Supreme Court seat open for nearly a calendar year while President Obama was in office, but are now rushing to fill the seat for a president whose campaign is under investigation by the FBI. Even Rep. Nunez, the Republican chairman of the House Intelligence Committee, said the investigation, confirmed yesterday by FBI Director Comey, puts a big gray cloud over this administration. You can bet if the shoe were on the other foot and a Democratic president was under investigation by the FBI, the Republicans would be howling at the moon about filling a Supreme Court seat in such circumstances. After all, they stopped a president who wasn't under investigation from filling a seat with nearly a year left in his presidency. It is unseemly to be moving forward so fast on confirming a Supreme Court justice with a lifetime appointment while this big gray cloud of an FBI investigation hangs over the presidency.
How about not unseemly? How about borderline criminal? How about they stole a Supreme Court seat and now they're going to appoint a far-right radical ideologue to overturn decades of progress in every area of American life? I mean, it's optics, but especially when you have no actual power, optics really matter, and the words you choose really matter. And I think in some ways Schumer there is distilling to an essence the problems with the Democratic response under his leadership, at least in the Senate. You have people like Sheldon Whitehouse, Bernie Sanders, making structural critiques of everything from the fraudulent judicial philosophy that propels someone like Neil Gorsuch to the entire macro assault of the whole Republican agenda on over 99% of the population. Then you have this odd fusion of it's unseemly, which is an incredibly mild way of describing political warfare. And then at the same time, we just point back again just to the Russia stuff, which again, I've said a million times, it's totally valid to investigate. There is, at the very least, the very real possibility of something there, but it's not the whole game. So, you know, Chuck Schumer demonstrating once again that his communication shop is filled with Clinton alums.
Just to push back a bit and to argue for Chuck Schumer, I think it does.
Thank you, young man. I appreciate it.
I think it does sort of lay the groundwork here for them leaving that seat open. Like, we're not going to get all the senators to come on board to fight the Trump's economic agenda to stop this nomination go through. So if you can use one of these issues, Benghazi-like, if you want to use that metaphor again, to get everyone else on board, you know, I'm kind of okay with it.
Well, we'll see. Maybe that'll work. Maybe Russia is the glue that binds Joe Manchin and Bernie Sanders. That's hopefully you're right.
Hey, everybody. Sam Seder here.
Donald Trump is a bad guy. Believe me. It's true.
It is true. And you can subscribe to this channel by subscribing to this channel. It's true.